One of these things is not like the others because he died. Yeah, so there was a little bit of an accident. I was being a little bit careless. And now our Charmander stand looks more like, more like that. It's a very long story, but I had to have him on the floor because I was recording something else for the main channel. And so I'm just going to set the lamps underneath this desk. That one fell on its side and I didn't realize it. And decapitated it and removed its arm by running it over with my chair. I'm fairly certain that my heart broke the second I heard the sound. It looks like if we can glue this back in place perfectly, it'll actually look okay. You might see a couple little lines. My lady friend makes stuff out of resin, so she's going to try and fix this. Also, yes, I know we're not doing the usual intro on the green screen, so we're kind of doing it here. If you don't care, I'll have a timestamp down below for when the intro ends. There we go. We have a fixed... don't fall. Don't fall. You have to stay standing for this video, okay? We have a fixed Charmander. As long as his head can stay stable... That looks so bad. But yes, this video is being fast-tracked. That means that you're getting three videos this week and not two because I have waited too long to do Pokemon Go. Very long story short, I ordered an Elite Trainer box. There was an issue with it and I didn't get the Elite Trainer box. I have another one on the way and normally I like to start any new set with an Elite Trainer box. But I ended up getting this first at my local card store. So the ETB will be coming at a later date. But as usual, my first time opening a new set, I have done almost no research, so I barely even know what's in this, set. But don't worry, the ETB is coming, it shouldn't be too long, hopefully. Oh yeah, and because this video is being fast-tracked, in the next so many videos, you're going to see him perfectly fine. He won't be resined together, because if those videos were filmed before his head got chopped off. I think that I'll go up until, like, the end of this month, then it'll be, back to current, timeline, post decapitation. So yes, I picked the, I guess the intro ends here. I picked the Team Mystic box, as that is the team I went with in Pokemon Go. I would still like to pick up the other two boxes, so expect to see those on this channel on one point or another. But I had to do Team Mystic just because that's the team that I picked. The funny thing is, I would have gone with Valor, and I almost went with Valor whenever the game first released. The only reason I didn't, the reason I wanted Valor is because Zapdos is my favorite out of the legendary bird boys. Pretty nice looking display right here, if I had to say so. We'll look at the bonus stuff here in a minute. Let's just go ahead and start with my first pack of this. But the only reason I went with Team Mystic is when I was at work, basically every one of my coworkers went Mystic. And I was like, okay, I guess I should join in so I'm not in some tiny team. That's a very beautiful backing to that pack. All I ever see is this. That is, I like that. That is very different. But let's split this thing open. I think the only thing I don't like is that all the pack arts are identical in this set. Alright, so I imagine the pack trick is going to be the same. But is it going to be a pull or a flip? Please be a pull. It is! So there's your code card. Now we can flip it. We do three to the front. We get rid of our energy. And let's see what we have. So first off, I think my brightness is too high. Maybe that's better. First off, we have our Chansey Zatu, and they all have the Pokemon Go symbol. I saw that in the few cards I've seen before. I didn't know if that would be on every card or if it was like a select thing. I find that to be kind of annoying. I mean, that kind of does the job down there. But, I mean, it makes sense. I can't complain too much. We got the Pikachu. There's a holo of Pikachu that I saw that I really want, although I'm sure it has, like, no value. We got the Burbarrel. Okay, well, for our first reverse slot. So I didn't know these Radiant cards went in the reverse slot. I actually have seen Radiant Venusaur, and I'm fairly certain he's one of the ones that's kind of sought after. Okay. Well, of course, I'm happy because he's my favorite of the original three starters. That is sick. I don't know how rare it is, though. I don't know how to gauge my excitement levels and what they should be right now. But just for the artwork alone and just for it being Venusaur, I can definitely say I am super happy about that. And here on the end, we have a Melmetal holo. Okay. The boy I still don't have in game because I don't really play much Pokemon Go at all anymore. And I haven't gone through all the tasks needed to get Meltan or to evolve him. I don't even know exactly how it works. Please donate your extra Meltan to a small YouTuber. Don't worry, all of the cards today will be getting sleeved. I'm just not doing it on camera right now. All right, let's go ahead and look at this. When the day comes that I ever get back into Pokemon Go, maybe I can, like, put this on my jacket or something, go out to the park and find other Pokemon Go people. There's actually a park near me that even, like, a year or two after Pokemon Go released, whenever I had gotten back into it again, me and a few friends, mostly coworkers, went out to this park, and there were other people playing Pokemon Go there. So maybe I can be a nerd and wear the Team Mystic badge here. That is pretty cool, though. I really do like this this pin. It's like almost like a shield design in the backing. All right, let's do our next pack. We have our Mewtwo boy right there on the front of it. I think, is it Mewtwo V-Star that was in this set? See, I don't normally do research on these, but I did technically a little bit because I happened to see them. Not really that I was intentionally looking things up on it. But I'm fairly certain Mewtwo V-Star was in this set. Maybe I'm wrong. So there's your code card. We do three to the front. We get rid of our energy. I wonder if there are V-Star tokens in this set. So we have the Egg Incubator, my favorite item. We have Solrock Boy and the Lore Module as all of the uncommons. Going on to our Pidove, our adorable little Bulbasaur. Our Squirtle, we already pulled that beautiful looking thing. Our Bidoof, I like how it's like almost like a Japanese wave art. We have Onix. Ambipom as our reverse. We did just get a standard reverse, but he's hanging from the signs. What a good little monkey boy. And on the end, we have a holo Glissopod. I'm wondering if holos are guaranteed in this subset. I mean, I've only done two packs. It's too early for me to say that. Of course, you guys will probably already know. You've probably already done or at least watched their Pokemon Go stuff. But I like to go in blind to every set. All right, let's hop into another pack. Then we will look at our promo that came with it. I would still love to get all three promos, so I am really hoping to do all three boxes. I did pay over retail for this box, and I know I could have gotten it cheaper on resale markets like eBay. But I recently had another card store open up in my area. They actually moved to our area. They closed their old location. And there's the code card. And I needed, I wanted to do a Pokemon Go thing for this channel sooner rather than later. My next, and so there are V-Star tokens in this. My ETB that I ended up ordering won't be here for a while. So I was like, all right, I'll pay over retail for this just so that way I can get the thing. I will say I like my first other, there's some like fraying going on up here. I'm not sure if that's really seeable. But like, you know, like I'll pay over for this, but yeah, this local card store, this new one, their prices are definitely higher. That is a beautiful Charmander. I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry. We'll fix you. We'll fix you as good as we can. I'm hoping that you won't even be able to tell that it was ever broken. I tried to find it online, by the way. I bought all of these for $20 each, so $60 altogether. The only one of those, I can only find one person selling that Charmander lamp, and it is $60 by itself. Anyways, yeah, so my that other card store, they have a lot more stock, and it's probably because they keep their prices higher. So if I want to like try to get something that I know I want and I'm seeking out specifically, going there is probably a good bet. There's a higher chance they'll have it. I'm pausing here because I want to point out that the artwork for this set, some of them are just, I love it. Look at this freaking Apom, man. Oh, whoops, I forgot. I was doing a little camera zoom. I'm trying something out new with my camera, and I forgot to zoom it back in after I had to pause there. We have our beautiful Bulbasaur again, our Pidove. We have our Magikarp. Rather 3D looking, makes sense for Pokemon Go being out there on the lake. Okay, so we have, she's not a leader, is she? She's not one of the Professor, she's not the one for... Crap. Valor. No. Yes? No? I don't remember all the professors. And we have Charizard from Pokemon Go. Now, I assume that this has not a whole lot of value behind it, which normally Charizard means it does. It's probably pretty high for a standard holo from this set, but I guarantee you if there's a Radiant Venusaur, then there's going to be a Radiant Charizard, and that's going to be where the value is at and where the, you know, big Charizard people are actually looking for, but still a very nice looking card. And I could be wrong, for all I know, this is worth a lot. You guys will have already seen the price down below. Very nice looking holo though, and I'm very much more convinced that holos are guaranteed in this set. I think that's a pretty safe call now that we are three packs in. That or I'm getting super lucky. All right, and here is the promo Blanche. I don't know exactly how you pronounce it. I'm guessing Blanche is how it's normally pronounced. Blanche? I don't know. Very nice looking card. Like, I really like the artwork on that. It's just a full art trainer. It's, you know, technically a full art. Very nice looking. I love the holo around the borders. That's a thing that they do with all holos in Japan. Nice looking promo. And if you want this entire box, but digitally, there is the code card. Out of focus. Still, there you go. Moving on, we are down to our last three packs. I might do an extra pack in here as well, as I just happen to still have a bunch of extra packs. But of course, it won't be from Go. That's the downside of these subsets, is they don't just sell, like, the cardboard packs, and they don't sell, like, you know, booster boxes and all of that. It's the, like, one downside to all of these subsets. You do three to the front, get rid of our energy. And we have a Charmeleon going up after our Charmander there. We have our Pupitar and our Chansey again. As all of our uncommons, we have the Burbirl. I think something kind of peaked out there. We might have something good coming up. We have a Meltan, the Magikarps at the lake again, our Aipom again, Charmander again. It's a small set, my guys. We have Wartortle as our reverse. Okay, beautiful looking card. Very happy to have that as a reverse. Probably worth 20 cents. Price is down there. But that, oh my, okay, I am falling in love with this Pokemon Go set. I'm not even that big of a Pokemon Go person. And on the end, we have a Melmetal V-Max. It's been a little bit since I've seen a V-Max. I don't think we've pulled any too recently. But very, very nice looking for a V-Max. I still don't care much for V-Maxes. I hate that all of the backgrounds are basically the same. But for Melmetal, this actually looks really cool. And I actually think the background and all the swirly crap is very fitting and looks very nice for this specific Pokemon. Don't get me wrong, I don't hate VMAXs. I still like pulling them, of course. But I just hate that they're all very samey. Two more packs to go. We've actually done great on pulls here. I'm assuming that pull rates for this set just happen to be good. Like, I'm just assuming that pull rates for the Pokemon Go set are just high. But again, I'm not certain. I could just be getting amazing luck. But with me, that's the unlikely answer to what is happening here. There's a Psychic Energy, and we have a Spark. Okay, that is from the Instinct. We have Ariados and the Steelix. Going on to our little 3D Eevee. Beautiful Numel. I don't want to say donut. It's too, like, fat to be a donut. There's a name for, like, a cake that is, like, large like that with, like, a hole in the center. And I can't remember what it's called. It's, like, kind of rounded. Yeah, Numel's looking, like, pretty edible today. We have Aeolian Raticate, Tranquil, Bulbasaur, Larvitar as our reverse, so no other Radiant here, but I do like our little Larvitar holding the berry. But lastly, we have Blastoise Holo. Okay, all I need is the Venusaur Holo, and I will be happy to have all three of those from this set. That is a very nice looking holo. Again, the artwork for this set. Like, a couple of the cards feel like, yeah, I could see that in just, you know, Vivid Voltage or whatever. But a lot of them have just been, like, so unique to Pokemon Go. In my opinion, very, very nice looking. For our bonus pack, I still have one more Go pack to do. But should I do something, like, weird and wacky? Should I do a Brilliant Stars, Astral Radiance, Fusion Strike? I don't know. You know what? We've had good pulls. We're going to do weird and wacky and not expect much. A recent eBay order I did came with this. They wrote thank you on it, and it came with a three-pack thing from Sun and Moon Forbidden Light. Kind of older at this point. We're going to do this. Yeah, it was a nice extra little freebie. I love when eBay sellers do that. It's not much, but hey, it's a nice way to get customers to appreciate you more. It has been so long since I've done these little dollar packs. I could not tell you if there's any sort of pack trick. Oh, right. This is pre code cards or no, I'm guessing there aren't code cards in these dollar ones. I remember. But we're just going to go through it. There's probably some sort of pack trick, but we have an Esper, a Honedge, and a Fossil Excavation Map. Nothing good, but I mean, it's a dollar pack. You don't usually get great. But hey, I'm happy with it. Anyways, we still have one more pack. Then, of course, we have our bonus card of the day, which I actually have a very special thing for today, and it's actually a complete mystery to me, but it has also been hand-picked. Anyways, let's open up our last Pokemon Go pack. I'm loving this set, and I'm definitely going to be doing a lot more of this. I believe the next thing for Pokemon Go will be the Elite Trainer box, but after that, man, I might even pick up another Elite Trainer box, as they're actually not too expensive in the resellers market. Three to the front, and for our final pack, we have Candela again. I'm guessing that's how that's pronounced. We have a Lunatone and a Rare Candy, as all of our uncommons. Going on to our Aolan Rattata, very nice looking. I love that he's going through like a dark street. We have our Edible Numble, Aolan Raticate, Tranquil, love our Tar with the Berry, Sylveon as our reverse. I don't think I pulled the energy card out. We'll find out. I think I forgot. But not a terrible thing to get as a reverse. I don't think we've pulled a Sylveon yet, have we? But on the end, okay, fitting. And yeah, we did forget the energy. Melmetal V, very fitting to pull this with the VMAX in a single six-pack box. Okay, I'm happy. I think we did pretty good today. It is now time for the bonus card of the day, and I told you something special was happening. My lady friend went and bought out some cards specifically for the bonus card of the day, and I have no idea what any of these could be. She also put some things in here to where I couldn't be spoiled as to what cards are inside, and we just did Team Mystic. This top letter happens to have blue on the side, so we're gonna do this one. Again, this video is being fast-tracked, so the next couple of videos will be the more standard card of the day, but then after that, we will be continuing with more of the cards that she picked up just for this, so that way I would be going in completely blind. Now, I assume there is only one card in this. Oh my god. Okay. First off, very nice fitting sleeve. We have the Dark Raichu, and I believe that's Legendary Collection? I'm fairly certain. I'm so bad with some of my vintage sets. Dark Raichu. I am a huge fan of the Dark cards. This is in absolutely immaculate condition. I don't really do PSA stuff, but there's some whitening down there at the bottom and a tiny bit at the top. Even with that, I'd have to say, as a guess, it'd probably be at least, at minimum, an 8, possibly as high as a 9. That is such great condition. I think, yeah, so that was the only thing in that hard sleeve. He'll be going back into another one. That is sick. Well, she definitely picked good. I am happy. God knows what it's actually worth. You guys will have already seen the price. So I also had to pause the camera to take a short break to let it cool down, and I went ahead and sleeved all of the stuff. But I also looked up a little bit on the set, and I actually learned about the Ditto cards. I'm sure you guys already know, but in case you don't, there are some cards that will have a Ditto logo right down here next to this symbol. If it is, you actually peel the front off of the card, and there will be a Ditto hiding underneath. I went through all of my cards. We didn't have any. It makes me sad. But now I want to aim to at least get one Ditto card. Anyhow, we are doing the end of video recap. Everything that was a reverse or better. We had the Larvitar, Sylveon, Ambipom, Candela, Wartortle. And for our holos, we had the Galissopod, the Melmetal, the Charizard, and the Blastoise. Then we go on to all of our good hard sleeve stuff. We have the Melmetal V, the Melmetal VMAX, the Promo Blanche, however you pronounce it, and of course, the beautiful Radiant Charizard. These things have all been sleeved in my fancy double-sealed sleeves, so they're basically waterproof at this point, and then put into these top loaders. And if any card deserves that treatment today, it is certainly this Radiant Venusaur. I will also be doing the same with this little guy. I assume he has a high enough value for me to worry about doing that, but either way, I want to, just to preserve this beautiful Dark Raichu. Either way, I really do hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know it was a fast-tracked boy, but hopefully we'll get more Pokemon Go going in the regular format. But on the upside, you guys got three videos this week rather than the regular two, and you got to cry with me about the decapitated Charmander. Let's not lie about what it is. He's been decapitated. He's not broken. He's dead. But again, my lady friend's going to actually try and fix that later today, so hopefully I won't be doing this. I mostly did that as a joke, but I won't be doing that anymore. Also, just, what a nice box. I appreciate this. This is nice. It's a nice little attention to detail. Oh, I actually forgot. Sorry. as I don't play a whole lot of Pokemon Go, I figured at least one of you guys could get more out of this than I could. So here, I'm blurring out the QR code. I can't make it too easy on you. Here are a bunch of codes. They're not really showing too well on camera. Maybe if I, like, adjust. I guess this thing comes with Pokemon Go products, and it gives you codes that can give you things in-game, including some, like, customization stuff for your character. I looked a little bit at the list of things you could get. So hopefully you guys get something good out of that. If you do take any of these codes, let me know. Did you get anything good? In the future, I might end up taking one of those for myself, just because I want to, you know, try it out for myself. But I'll give the first one away, at the very least. Either way, I really hope you guys enjoyed. Sorry about the rambling, and sorry if this video might have been a little bit too long. I basically just woke up, and I just got over being sick twice in a row. So my brain is still a little melty. I really do hope you guys enjoyed the video. Give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and hopefully I'll see you guys in just a couple days. Goodbye for now.